Hello everyone, welcome to your very own channel sonisinghphysics. Before I start the content of this video, I want to share something with you. You know, I was getting requests from my student that ma'am, there is no any channel where we can get the systematic content of igcse physics. So I thought I'll help you in this way. So I have started from chapter 1, already prepared a video on measurement where it is about the vernier caliper and screw gauge, and this is very effective video. In 7 minutes you can understand it very well, what is pitch, what is least count, and how we take measurement from these two micrometers. This is the second video in that series, which is based on scalars and vector. In the beginning of the video, I'll provide you small crisp notes, and along with that, there are some questions which is very effective, and each question is based on different concept. So I hope so this video is going to be helpful for you, and to get the maximum benefit of the content, please watch the whole video. Thank you. Let us start the content. These are some of the questions through which we can easily understand about scalar and vector, which is normally a difficult task for grade 10 or igcse student. So the first question is, which statement describes a vector? So vector means quantity which has magnitude and direction both. So here correct answer will be third one, it has both direction and magnitude. Next question, is this a scalar quantity or a vector? Wind blowing at 20 knots. So here there is no direction, only magnitude. So it will be a scalar quantity. Then in this question, which of these is not a vector quantity? So when you see these quantities, displacement, velocity and acceleration, we cannot describe them without direction. So definitely all these three are vector, but time. Time, we cannot say what is the direction of a time. So time is not a vector quantity over here. In this question, a car travels 90 meters due north and 40 meters due south. So first we'll draw the diagram, 90 meter due north and 40 meter due south. So we have to take any one side as a positive. So suppose we are taking north as a positive, then south will be negative, and when we add both the displacement, it will be 90 plus minus 40. So the answer will be 50 meter due north. That will be the answer for this question. This question, what is the magnitude of the resultant? So first we have to see that in which direction forces are working. Both the forces are working in the same direction, so both will have same symbol. So the resultant force will be 450 plus 450, that is 900 newtons. Let us see next question. Next question is, what is the magnitude of the resultant given in the picture? And if you can see, there is a two displacement, one 50 meter and then 20 meter, and both the vectors are at 90 degree to each other. So to find the resultant of this kind of vectors, we have to use Pythagoras theorem. So here resultant will be equal to 50 square plus 20 square root under, and when we'll calculate it, it will be nearby 55.60 meter. This is a very important question which is frequently asked in exam. In practice A of the figure, what is the direction of the resultant displacement? So here we already learned in the previous question that how to find the resultant with the help of Pythagoras theorem. And for the direction, what we need to do, we need to use tan theta. Tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent. So you can take either this angle or you can take that angle. So if you are taking this angle, then as per the tan theta formula, it will be opposite by adjacent, and opposite will be 5, adjacent will be 10. So it will be 1.2 tan inverse 0.5. So tan inverse 0.5 will be 27 degree, and it will be 27 degree north of west. So that is the way how to find the direction. In this kind of question, we have to use tan theta. This is another important question. Calculate the magnitude and direction of two forces of 3 Newton and 4 Newton acting at right angle to each other. So it is similar kind of question I have already discussed with you. So all of you try, answer is already given, and just see that whether you are getting the same answer or not. So friends, I hope this video is helpful for you to understand scalars and vector. So before signing off, do not forget to subscribe and comment your very own channel, Sonisinghphysics.